The booster for Flight 9 has been officially launched. While the choice may be surprising, along with it, the Cygnus mission, responsible for resupplying the ISS, has undergone significant modifications due to complications with the spacecraft. Furthermore, the composition and schedule for Crew 11 have been revealed. Let's talk more about it. In today's episode of NR Studio, we are about to launch Flight 9 and preparations are in full swing. However, an important question remains. Which booster will be used for this mission? There are two worthy contenders, the B-16, currently engaged in active testing, and the B-14, which was previously operational during Flight 7. The resolution seems clear. The B-14 is expected to be reused for the upcoming Flight 9. This decision is rational, as the B-14 is in optimal condition for a quick turnaround, especially when compared to the B-12, which has suffered some damage, and the B-15, which has just been introduced. The aircraft demonstrated a remarkably smooth and controlled landing during Flight 7, positioning it as a prime candidate for future reuse. Recent progress lends additional credibility to this decision. While the B-15 and B-12 have been moved to Rocket Garden for storage, the B-14 remains at Megabay 1, undergoing extensive repairs and evaluation. The most plausible reason for this is that it is undergoing preparation for additional flights. At the same time, the B-16, despite its continued preparation, has faced several setbacks. For example, it remained at the Massey test site for several weeks after the completion of cryogenic testing. While this additional time may have been intended to provide greater oversight to prevent complications that were encountered on previous flights, the slow progress suggests that the B-16 is unlikely to be ready for Flight 9. The B-14 reuse marks a significant milestone for Starship and SpaceX. Achieving partial reusability marks a significant breakthrough, further cementing Starship's status as the next-generation rocket of choice. Competing launch systems, such as ULA Vulcan and NASA SLS, do not have reusability capabilities. Blue Origin. New Glenn was engineered with an emphasis on reusability. However, it has yet to make its maiden flight. SpaceX's Neutron still has a lot of progress to make before it can achieve full reusability. If SpaceX can successfully reuse Starship boosters, it would be a monumental leap forward, propelling the company even further into the competitive landscape of commercial space exploration. For the B-14, this venture presents a tremendous opportunity. It has the potential to be the first Starship booster to perform multiple launches. Reaching this milestone would be a significant step toward full reusability, effectively bringing Starship closer to the operational competence of the Falcon rocket range. Another important milestone to note is engine reusability. SpaceX has made significant progress in this regard by reusing engine 314 during Flight 7, which marked the B-14 maiden flight. This engine had previously operated on the B-12 during Flight 5. If engine 314 takes to the skies once again on Flight 9, it will have completed three launches, marking a significant milestone in the field of rocket reusability. As the B-14 prepares for Flight 9, important questions arise about its performance. Unfortunately, indications are that Mechazilla's arm will not be able to secure B-14 for recovery. Instead, it is likely that the spacecraft will sink in the ocean, indicating that Flight 9 will be the B-14's final operation. While this is a disappointing development, especially considering the B-14's historic role as one of the first Starship boosters to be successfully landed and refurbished, it may be a calculated strategic move. SpaceX has not provided an official reason for the decision not to retrieve the booster. However, several plausible explanations are possible. First, the launch tower's capture mechanism may have been undergoing an upgrade, making it inaccessible to Flight 9. Second, and perhaps more likely, SpaceX may have emphasized the spacecraft's performance during this particular mission, prioritizing the successful completion of the entire upper stage flight profile may have been of utmost importance. By successfully retrieving the booster in the ocean, SpaceX optimized its operations and reallocated more resources to confirming the spacecraft's re-entry and landing protocols. Despite its ocean landing, the B-14 reusability represents significant progress. It shows that SpaceX is making significant strides toward achieving Starship reusability, a critical element in reducing costs and increasing launch frequency. Are you excited about this major milestone? Show your enthusiasm by commenting, "Let's go B-14" below. And don't forget to like the video and subscribe to our channel to stay updated on SpaceX's incredible journey. If B-14 is selected for the upcoming flight, SpaceX will need to accelerate its preparations to facilitate a smooth launch experience. After a few weeks in Megabay 1, B-14 is ready to begin its testing phase. Unlike a complete overhaul, SpaceX may choose to retain the majority of its engines, opting to replace only a select few when necessary. As a result, we can anticipate that B-14 will undergo cryogenic testing using a fully integrated engine configuration. Given that changes to its engines are anticipated to be minimal, B-14 will likely progress through the testing phase at a commendable pace. Following the completion of cryogenic testing, it is anticipated that the transition to static fire testing will occur shortly. There is a potential scenario where cryogenic testing could be skipped altogether. If that happens, B-14 could potentially be transported to the launch pad next week for static fire evaluations. Following completion of this critical phase, it will proceed through standard pre-launch evaluations and system validations, further advancing it toward flight readiness. Compared to the B-16, the preparation schedule for the B-14 has shown much greater efficiency, increasing the likelihood of an April launch. Indeed, if the testing process goes smoothly, Flight 9 could happen sooner than many anticipate. What are your estimates for the launch date if the B-14 is utilized? We welcome your insights in the comments. However, it is imperative that the systems on the launch pad are fully restored to operational capacity before further preparations can begin. Following Flight 8, despite minor complications such as damage to the vaporizer system and some debris scattered across the launch site, the core infrastructure, including the orbital launch pad, launch tower, and suction cup, appears to be largely intact. With only minor repairs or component replacements required, the launch pad is expected to be fully ready to host future Starship missions without significant delay. Additionally, in order for the launch to proceed on schedule, SpaceX is required to complete an FAA-mandated accident investigation following Flight 8. Addressing the issues that emerged from the previous two explosions was indeed a top priority. However, given that the issues encountered in Flight 8 were very similar to the anomalies observed in Flight 7, it is expected that the process of resolving them will be relatively quick. With all these elements in mind, the upcoming Starship launch is just around the corner, which is a significant step forward in SpaceX's ambitions for full reusability and expeditions to space. Are you ready to enter the next era of space exploration? Let's now turn our attention to the latest developments regarding the Cygnus resupply mission to the International Space Station. Following a series of vehicle complications, the upcoming Northrop Grumman Cygnus cargo resupply mission to the International Space Station, designated NG-22, has been officially canceled. The NG-22 mission was delayed from February to June due to challenges encountered during the delivery process of the vehicle. NASA and Northrop Grumman immediately began an investigation into the matter, and their findings revealed that the cargo module intended for the mission had suffered severe damage, making it unfit for flight. As a result, NASA has decided to cancel the NG-22 mission altogether. The upcoming Cygnus mission, designated NG-23, is now scheduled to launch as early as fall of this year. This means that Cygnus will refrain from contributing to the ISS resupply mission for a full year, given that the most recent Cygnus mission, NG-21, launched in August 2024. Dan Leone, a representative for Northrop Grumman, provided additional insight into the matter. The pressurized cargo module designated for Northrop Grumman's NG-22 Cygnus cargo resupply mission was damaged during its transportation from its supplier to Northrop Grumman. An assessment of the potential impact on the NG-22 mission schedule is currently underway. In the meantime, we are diligently advancing hardware development for NG-23 with the goal of facilitating a launch as early as fall 2025. Our ultimate goal is to ensure the safe transport of cargo and supplies to the crew of the International Space Station on schedule. This progress underscores a continuing trend. In addition to SpaceX, other contractors tasked with resupplying the ISS face significant challenges. Boeing's Starliner program has left NASA frustrated by significant delays and complications encountered during crewed test missions. Currently, Northrop Grumman's Cygnus program is grappling with significant logistical and hardware constraints. With Cygnus no longer a viable option for the foreseeable future, NASA will need to rely heavily on SpaceX for its ISS resupply efforts. Upcoming SpaceX Dragon cargo missions will require additional supply hauls to offset Cygnus absence. In response, NASA is expected to recalibrate its cargo load by reducing the amount of research materials, prioritizing the addition of consumables, such as food and water, for the station crew. The next SpaceX Dragon cargo mission, designated CRS-32, is scheduled to launch as early as April 21st. As NASA and SpaceX work to address these challenges, attention will be focused on their approach to managing ISS logistics in the coming months. SpaceX remains critical in its contribution to the International Space Station, not only providing cargo resupply, but also ensuring the safe transportation of astronauts. Following the successful launch of Crew 10 and the safe return of Crew 9, which included two astronauts from Starliner, NASA and SpaceX have begun their initial preparations for Crew 11. The latest announcement from NASA has officially confirmed the personnel selected for the mission. The contingent will feature NASA astronaut Zena Cartman as commander, joined by Mike Fink, JAXA astronaut Kamiya Yui, and Roscosmos cosmonaut Oleg Plotnikov. Remarkably, Cartman was originally slated for Crew 9, but was later moved to make room for two returning Starliner astronauts. Meanwhile, Fink was originally selected for Starliner 1, Boeing Starliner's maiden operational crewed mission, subject to the vehicle receiving final certification. Given the numerous Starliner delays, the mission's prospects remain unclear. In terms of launch timeline, Crew 11 is currently scheduled for no earlier than July of this year. It's increasingly clear that SpaceX's contribution to ISS operations is critical. Dragon's reliability, coupled with the lack of alternative crewed spacecraft, has firmly established SpaceX as NASA's partner of choice for human spaceflight efforts. That's it for today's episode. See you in the next one, and thank you all for your support.